hi, Arena fans. We are going through all the characters very quick now, just to see how the special of them works. So we start with Benvik, our main character. It's the gladiator with the chain. So mainly he is for catching another figure, like this. So you just take the chain. You can make it short, you can make it long, as you wish. Then you go behind the base. Don't go over the base with your hands. Every special that you throw, you have to throw over the base, like this. Ah, didn't get her. So when I get her, like this, just, and she wants to run away, he keeps her. So this is one special to use him. And the other one is, you can do like this and try to throw the ball away out of the control. Again, stop at the base and the ball, should go away.
But we get the idea.
Yes, of course. So this is the main idea. Of course, there's the reload and everything, the details. It's all on the card. It's written on the card, on the special. So, and then we have Sim. It's the Sai. It's kind of an elfin race. They are fast and furious. So she has two talents. Right now she has dribbling. Dribbling means you can play the ball into the free room, free space, and try to get control again. Now, if she gets control again, your partner or another team character gets another action. So actually you have three actions if she gets the ball that she played into the free space. So this is dribbling. Now she has a sprint, she can change. You use one action to change. You can do this while playing. So now this was her action to change to sprint. And sprint means just play her twice. Play her twice. But you're not allowed to touch the ball or get in control of the ball. So if I want to sprint, I only could sprint behind the ball, for example. Go like this and like this. So I'm not allowed to control the ball with the second action.
To block other rays and
yes, and
shots
just make meters, okay? And go behind corners, like this. So this is Sim. Now the next one is Lislop. It's the torturer. He can tackle, slide tackle. Slide tackle means if you touch the ball that is controlled from another figure, you can say, I don't use my second action, my second team action, but then the other team has just one action. So for example, play the ball away and the turn of this team is over. So now we come to Tree. It's our half giant. So the half giant has the rock. He can throw it just to block some space, some area, because it's a hard obstacle. No one is allowed to touch the rock. This would be a fault. So another idea is to just throw the ball out of the control of a character.
Like with the chain, yeah?
Yeah, like this, he has the rock. Or if the rock is in his control area, he can use it. just pick it up and throw it like this. Oh my god! Again, try to get the ball out of the control. Yes.
Yeah, but normally you just have one try.
Of course. So, and the it's a weapon that you have to pick up. So he's not, he can't just get it back. He has to run there like this. Try to get in control of the rock. If you are there, you can use it in the next turn, or you can pick it up right now for maybe if you run to get it with you along. Okay?
Along with you, yeah.
Yeah. So.
Okay, that's three.
That's three. Now we that's have.
That are the four basic characters.
These are the four basic characters in the basic pledge of Kicked Arena. Now the two additional characters, it's Torch and Wendy. So we start with Torch. Torch is a shortling and he has six flames. It's cloth. And you have to throw it with one hand. So for example, it's fire. It's the German word, but we have the English too, of course. So I want to cover this area. I go behind. I don't have to stand behind the figure, but I have to throw to this direction and my hand has to be behind this line to throw, okay? So I just do it like this. And now there are the flames. And I did a kind of a ball, so it's all on one area. I can use these very very light and open like this. So there's different styles of casting the fire. Now I want to make a huge fire, spread out very wide, and I do it like this. So now I have a lot of flames all over the place.
And nobody's allowed
and
to
nobody
touch
is allowed to run over it or touch it. So for example, if I want to go to the ball there, I lose my second action if I touch a flame. So But I'm desperate to get the ball, so I just go through the flame. I touched it, I lose my second action, so my turn is done. That's, and he can reload it, it's a spell. He can say, I want to kill the fire and reload. So he just takes all flames away. And there's another chance to kill the fire for the opponent if he rests on a flame or touches, keeps touching the flame like this. Now he touches this flame under him, of course, and he touches this flame so he can kill the fire. And this is losing the second action. It's
yeah,
done.
Putting it out.
Yeah, yeah, he's putting it out. And it's out of the game. Okay? This is out of the game. So this is Torch.
But he gets it back when he reloads.
Of course,
he
always gets it back. It's a spell, it's not a physical. Lasting fire. So next one is Wendy. So we get Wendy with the teleport. Okay.
Yeah.
So you can keep it like this. You don't have to. It just fits. She can again throw it over the base and throw it anywhere with one hand. And you have to put your figure covering the ring. You're not allowed to put it beside the ring. It has to cover the ring totally.
Okay.
So it's 1.48 that she is teleporting herself to. So this is Wendy. Then we have Eason. So this is the pledge. Basic pledge, Kicked Arena, with the additional two figures. We recommend this very strong.
Of course. And
so
all the others.
These are the additional characters you can get as you like. So this is Isengard, or English Eisenbreed.
The ice breaker.
With the ice. Yes. These ice. Tiles, it's wood, So he can cast ice wherever he wants. You have to cast with one hand. All together, you're not allowed to use just one. So he can cast it. And this is a soft obstacle. So
you're allowed to touch it.
You're allowed to touch it. If you are here and you want to go to the wall, you have to, whoops. You have to go over the ice. It's not almost always that kind of an obstacle, but for example, if it's here and I want to get the ball now, this can really be tricky to get the ball, okay?
And to shoot, you are not allowed to touch the ice.
I'm not allowed to touch the ice with my feet.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's tricky, but it's still there. It will be. You can touch it. Everyone can touch it and push it around. So, and of course, the other one, how you can use it is
like chain and rock.
Like the chain and the rock. Okay. Pull the ball away.
Yeah, great.
Or a very good idea sometimes is when you really need to get rid of the ball where it's laying and you can't go there. For example, like this. Now he's able to go here and do a direct shot at the goal. I can't go to the ball to do anything, but what I can do is just try to kill the ball away.
Yeah.
Should go there. Like this. So this is Isenbrüt.